In this video, we have a cool AI app idea for you that you can build using no-code tools such as Bubble or Flutterflow. We're going to go through the idea and also use a new tool, a new AI tool, to visualize what this could look like. We'll talk about why this app is tailor-made for the subscription model and also talk about how you can get new paying users. Let's get straight into the idea before looking at how we can build this out. Now, this idea came to me because I've been using ChatGPT for this reason. But as you know, using an app is much more streamlined when it comes to getting AI responses. Now, the app idea is this. It's an AI-powered meal planning app that will create tailor-made recipes based on people's preferences, including calorie intake, food preferences, the time of the day of the meal, and much more. This is highly valuable because when it comes to trying to find recipes, it's very hard to find them online, or it takes a lot of time to sift through all the ads on the page to get the meal that you want. Whereas what this app is going to do is it's going to allow users to input their preferences. So this could be dietary restrictions, type of cooking equipment that they have, how many people are turning up for the meal, and just much more. And then it's going to use AI to create specific recipes for the user. And in fact, let's get a visual for this using Bolt.new. Seth has used Bolt.new recently just to show how powerful this is, but I used it very quickly just to create a home page, a personal profile page for an app like this. So I gave it a prompt and it came up with recipe AI. So you could enter your personal details here, your health goals, your dietary preferences, allergies and restrictions, and cuisine preferences. So you can imagine somebody going on this as their homepage, entering these details and more details and saving the preferences. So then from there, AI is going to use these preferences when it creates recipes in the future. And then you can think of other features such as being able to save recipes, modifying other recipes that people use, and then also having AI analyze food items for you. So we can give you a shopping list based on what you want to get for the week, based on the recipes for the week. Personally, I would find this super useful because it's going to give me the ingredients I need for the week and save me time when it comes to the weekly shop. Now, before we talk about monetization and pricing, we're going to quickly talk about how to build this. So there are two apps that we think you can use for this. There are other ones as well, but two popular apps are going to be Bubble and also Flutterflow. Now, we actually have a tutorial on this inside No Code MBA on how to build out a basic recipe app using Flutterflow. So click the link in the description to go to that. But also know you can build this out using Bubble, and we have courses on Bubble inside No Code MBA too. But you would build out the basic structure for the app, and then you would connect this to something like OpenAI using the API connector so that you can introduce that AI element into the app. Now, in the last app idea, we talked about how having a resume builder, and I'll leave a link to that video in the description, doesn't really lend itself to a subscription model for most people, because most people get their resume, find a job, and then they don't need that resume builder maybe for years. Whereas an AI-powered recipe app is going to be a tool that people will use on an ongoing basis. So just like the last one, a freemium model is going to work really well. So this is where people can try out the app for free. Maybe they can create one recipe based on the ingredients that they want to include. But for people to create multiple recipes, to save shopping lists, to search for where they can find the food items from, this is going to be the subscription model. And you can have 1 to 3 tiers of the paid app. Now, you might want to start out with a simple pricing model to begin with and then add to this pricing model over time. And that's something many AI developers and startups have talked about when creating their apps. So look at the case studies that we've done. Again, a link in the description, and just go through their advice on this. So let's say that you have this recipe app built. You have the basic model. It's ready to ship, and you're excited about people signing up for it. The next stage is to promote it. Now, we have a video where we talked about common practices that people use when promoting their own app. But the freemium model means that people can try it out for free, and if they like it, they're going to share it. And this is how you can get organic reach over time once you do the heavy lifting at the beginning by sharing it with relevant people. But a great thing you can do here is also work with influencers, especially in the health and fitness space and people who create recipes. You can do two things here because they're not going to promote this for free in the vast majority of cases. The first thing you can do is to do a paid advertisement on their page. You can sponsor a video, and you'll know what this is if you've spent any time on YouTube, where the YouTuber promotes a product in the video. So you can pay for your product to be promoted on relevant YouTube channels. And the second way is to start an affiliate program where you can reach out to the same type of influencers in the field and industry and ask them to feature your product and talk about the affiliate program. And a lot of the time, people do a combination of these two things. Now, as your app grows, you can think about all the different partnerships you can have. So you can actually monetize in different ways inside the app. For example, you can partner with grocery delivery services. You can partner with specific brands so they can put their brands in front of people. And you can include different products inside the app and have affiliate partnerships with those brands. So that is the idea, an AI-powered recipe building app. Now, if you want to learn the technical side of building this type of app, then go to nocode.mba, where you can learn all about how to build with no-code and AI from the top no-code instructors. And like I said before, we have a new course on Flutterflow that goes through how to build this recipe app. And if you prefer to build it on Bubble, we have tutorials covering that as well. Now, if you got something from this video, then please click that like button and share it with a friend. And if you're going to stay on YouTube, then check out our playlist on other business ideas and also check out our playlist on the case studies to get excited and to get inspired from people who have built no-code applications. Be sure to subscribe to the channel. Thank you so much for watching, and I'll speak to you soon. Bye for now.